Hello everyone, Vanguard of Valor here, and welcome back to another episode of XCOM 2. Now, we just had a crazy mission last time. It was a disaster. If we take a look at our soldiers here, all of our top troops are gravely wounded. So, ouch. That did not work out exactly as we'd like. But you know what? We can deal with it. We have another team who are able to take their place, and our Advanced Warfare Center will be done in a day, so we should be able to help heal up our team to keep them in the fight. Most importantly, though, we now also have the ability to get some new items here. We can get Lightning Strike if we want, which is pretty cool, gaining some additional movement on the first couple turns of a fight. We can get Wet Work, so we get more experience gained from kills, so we level up faster, which is pretty good. Most importantly, we can get Squad Size 1. Yes! Alright, we have 5 soldiers to bring into fights now. That should help even the odds a little bit. Squad size 2 requires a captain, so it'll be a little while before we can get that one. But we'll do what we can, and hopefully we can do that. Oh, some shenanigans have been going on. I'd love to buy some more upgrades, but we need to be able to save that money to build things in our facilities, which should be soon, because the alien machinery will be cleared in 2 days, and then we can start work on clearing out the exposed power coil, because we need to be able to build some stuff, otherwise we're going to be in trouble. We also need to clear out this alien debris so we can start building our other centers here, so we've got a lot of stuff to do. A lot of stuff to do. I think what we're going to do right now... is we're going to stick another person in our guerrilla tactics school.
She might be a little worse for wear right now, but with some new schematics and a little elbow grease, she'll be the toughest thing in the sky.
All right, Lebedeva, I'm going to teach you to become what? You want another ranger? I think we have 2 of everything now. If we take a look at our team here, we have 3 specialists, 2 sharpshooters, 2 sharpshooters. Yep. 2 sharpshooters, 2 rangers, 2 grenadiers. Okay. Let's get a second... Let's make you a third grenadier.
New orders, Commander?
Lebebda. Wrong place. I need to go here. Alright. Let's train you up. Okay, let's train you up. There we go. And we're gonna make you a grenadier, I think. There you go. We don't have another one of those yet. Oh, look, there's suddenly people working out in here. I only have 1 person training, but there's 4 people in the room all of a sudden. What do you know? All right, so that was a mess. Let's head back to the bridge. Keep working on making contact with our eastern United States. Ooh, an airstrip. Resistance contacts. I don't know what that does. I've never seen that one before. I have not played enough of it. Hidden reserves. What does that do? +5 to Avenger power. Oh, that's really good. Well, it's really good right now, because it'll mean we can start building more stuff. The future benefit of it is maybe not quite as powerful as some of the other continent bonuses might be, but you know what? I'm not going to complain anymore. We're going to head over and make contact with the Eastern U.S., because we want to make that
Eastern United States
now, so we get that power right away.
Commander, we have a priority message coming through. It looks
never
like
mind.
An encoded signal from the Resistance.
All right.
Through to your quarters now.
What's this all about?
Hello, Commander. It would seem your recent activities have gotten Advent's attention. Our unwelcome guests are on the move. Advent has been diverting considerable resources and personnel to covert facilities across the globe. The exact details of these operations are highly classified. However, they do have one thing in common. A single word that appears in all their files. Avatar. I believe the black site we had previously uncovered to be but a part of this Avatar project. Based on what we have uncovered so far, its true scope is far greater. This project is being directed from the very top of Advent, from a source I am still unable to determine. All attempts to uncover its identity have met with failure. It is time to take a more direct approach. Though we may not know the exact nature of this Avatar project, we can still disrupt it. We must root out these hidden facilities with the help of local resistance cells, disrupt our enemy's operations, and in the process, uncover the truth. Locate the source of this Avatar project, and then destroy it. Were the enemy to succeed in their efforts, I am certain it would mean the end for us all. I am confident you will take whatever measures necessary to eliminate this threat, Commander.
Well, we've got our Doom Tracker now.
We're tracking the aliens' progress on this Avatar project here. If they finish what they've started, it sounds like it'll be the end for all of us.
The completion of the Avatar project is the aliens' ultimate goal, Commander. We must stop the project before it's too late. Oh, good. There are already three nubs in. Bad business, folks. Bad business. Let's make contact with the Eastern United States. Same random gentleman as before.
We're reading you.
There we go. We got another 66 supplies in our income. And
regional contacts
we can now go to Western Europe instead. The other nice thing is we now have hidden reserves. I think we have to build a second radio relay on the continent to get the bonus, though, which I forgot about completely, so that's unfortunate. How much does it cost us to build a radio relay, and do I even want to build one yet? I don't think I do. I think what we have to do first is we have to go attack this facility here so they tell us which direction the other one's in. Because if we have to build another radio relay, we're going to want to make sure we build it in the right direction so we're not wasting our resources any more than we have to. The suit-up bonus is over here. What does that do? Proving ground projects, armor and vest proving ground projects are completed instantly. Europe has spy ring. Make all intel rewards increase by 25%. Interesting. Is there anything else? Looks like there's only three different bonuses. Maybe it's because I can only see those three areas. There's probably another one in here. Or in Africa. Yeah. Probably. Would not surprise me if there's an Africa or South America bonus that we just can't see yet, because we can't actually go this way. Alrighty, well then, we're in a pickle. I would love to get our Advanced Warfare Center. I don't know what this does. So we're going to probably head over here while we wait for our next upgrades to finish. Then we need to go attack this base.
Advanced Warfare Center now.
Alright, soldiers now have a chance to learn a bonus ability upon promotion. That's always great. And we can also put a staff in here to increase soldier healing rate. And we can retrain soldier abilities, which is pretty cool too. Alright, let's take a look at that facility, because you know what? As much as I'd like to do some other stuff, we might need to put somebody in here right away. The healing situation is a real problem. Alright, healing rate plus 100%. So hopefully our team won't take forever to recover from their wounds now. Are there people in here yet? Nah, nobody in there. That's fine. It'll take one day until we can move down and start clearing out the power coil, if that's how it works, and we'll find out shortly. Our wounded here should now only be wounded for a little while. If we take a look, they're wounded for 5, 4, 8, and 7 days. Oof. Such a long time. But the population in there should really help, and we can keep moving on and get some more stuff here. Oh boy. Is it better for me to start working on the power coil? It might be. I can't actually do that until this is done, though, so I might as well leave it there for now, and what we'll do is we'll wait another couple minutes until that advanced alien machinery is cleared out. Like so. There we go, we got 49 supplies and 13 alien alloys, and let's go take a look
maximum
at how this works.
Maximum power consumption reached.
Do we have to clear out the power coil? We have to shield the power coil, of course. This takes a while, as I understand it. That'll take 30 days. Oh, man. We do need to shield this thing, though, because we got to build some stuff on top of it. So I guess we'll start excavating it. Doot. And we'll go from there. Interesting. You can remove somebody from a facility like that when they're in progress. We can remove them here as well, which we might do. We have a backup team. They're not our A-team, though, and if we're gonna go take on that facility, we kind of need to have our A-team ready. Or at least some of our A-team. We don't need to have them all. We have backup soldiers that would be pretty good here. But they're only squaddies.
You've managed to do with this ship.
I just wish he had lived long enough to see us fight back. To know that it wasn't all for nothing.
Trust me, he knows.
I'd love to get some of our higher rank soldiers back. If we can wait 4 days, then we get our specialist and our grenadier, and that should be enough. We wouldn't have the ranger, which is not great. Baller, glitch, and spider. Very nice. The sharpshooter would be good too, because they actually have the squad site overwatch. But I think at this point, we gotta take what we can get, and that was a terrible loss we just suffered. A terrible loss we just suffered indeed. What do we do here? We don't want to waste too much time, because the longer we wait, the harder it'll be with things like Avatar Project picking up speed. I think what we're going to do is we're going to wait until at least most of our team is recovered, and then we're going to go attack the black site, because that's what we have to do. So let's spin this airstrip resistance contacts and see what it gives us, because I don't know what it does. Oh boy. Visser's recovered from her wounds. We now have Sophia. Fiona's back from their wounds. Supply raid. Uh-oh. Alright. The Resistance has relayed information concerning an Advent supply line. We should disrupt their transports. Well, we're probably gonna have to go do that with our B-team, and then we can send our A-team on the next mission. Raid the Advent train. Operation Bloodfather. Valuable alien technology, though. We're probably gonna need to go do that pronto, otherwise we're gonna miss out. So let's go do this. We'll come back and try and finish this mission, and then we'll go take on the Western U.S. secret mission there for the Advent Black Site. I don't like how all this shenanigans is happening, but we're not going to get around shenanigans no matter what we do. Let's go take on a train, apparently. We have 5 soldiers per mission now, which should make a difference. We've got a sniper, a grenadier, a specialist, another grenadier, another specialist. So we're going to need to change our team up a little bit. We're going to take both of our sergeants, as much as I don't want them to get damaged here, because we need them to actually level up. We're going to get rid of Kelly for now, and we're going to take our ranger, Lich. There we go. Okay. I want to make sure that our team have the right weapons. I believe you have the upgraded... yeah, you do. You have the stock on your weapon there. Payne, we're going to give you the sniper rifle. I didn't make it available yet, of course. Make weapons available. There we go. And now you get the sniper rifle. There you go. Now, I may have the ability to give some of these people another PCS. We have the Will one. I'm not sure who I want to give the Will PCS to, but I think I'm going to give it to Lynch. Because having our assault panic is not great. Can I do that from here? I should be able to. There we go. You can have the Will PCS. We have another weapon upgrade too, but I don't know if I want to give them the auto loader. It's got to be somebody who shoots a lot. Generally, our assaults do shoot a lot, so giving them the auto loader might not be a terrible thing. We only have one of them, so I have to give it to somebody who needs it. And right now, my main concern is either a grenadier, because they only have 3 shots, so being able to have 6 shots might make a big difference. They have the grenades, though, so they should be okay. Our snipers are normally fine. I think I'm going to give it to our shotgunner, like I was saying. Alright, let's upgrade our shotgun with an auto-reloader. What could possibly go wrong? Here you go. Feels appropriate on a shotgun, too, since it's a rack of shells on the side. Okie dokie. Let's do this thing, folks. We got a lot of grenades coming with us on this mission, so we should be able to clear out a lot of people. 4 in grenade launchers, which is what I'm counting on making a big difference. Let's do this thing. Difficulty says it's moderate. We'll see how it actually plays out for us. It's our first mission with a 5-person team, so that might make a difference, but I have a feeling this is going to be a pain no matter how it goes. Alright, Bloodfather, let's do this thing.
Resistance ambushed an advent train moving through an area of remote wilderness. And they've left plenty of cargo for salvage. That's where we come in. Once you're on the ground, eliminate all hostile contacts and secure the area. Seize anything of value.
We gotta kill people and get the supplies. I don't think I've ever actually seen a mission like this, so I have no idea how this is gonna work, but I guess we'll find out. Are we stealthy or are we coming in hot here?
Menace 1-5, coordinates of the advent train.
We're stealthy. Alright.
Move to secure. Eliminate all hostiles.
Do we know where the train is? Looks like there's no time limit on this one, which is really nice. Alright, Glitch. I think it's interesting, too, that the game gives them the names that their nicknames are. This looks like it'll expose us if we smash through here, because it's too loud. So what we're going to do is, we're going to move somebody who's further back, like Kim, who wouldn't be able to get all the way up, over to the wall
moving
and open the door
location.
For us.
Enemy sighted.
Aha! Already found somebody. Several somebodies, from the looks of it. Alright, well, we'll see about that. We're going to have you open the door for now. There we go. And we'll send Glitch through to... Come on. Why can't I move here? There we go. Move to there.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Sometimes the game just doesn't want you to go places. Alright, Visser. Baller it is. Let's send you over to here, maybe? High cover is better than low cover, so let's move you over to here.
Moving out.
It's a bit of an aggressive push forward, because we don't know where these guys are going. But I figure we might as well push up hard while we can. Move you over to here, Schultz.
Move.
Lynch, you're going to move over to this cover.
Copy that.
As a result, I want you mostly near the front. And I'm actually going to move Payne over to this side.
Rolling!
Should give her a good line of sight on these guys. Glitch, I'm not going to have you do anything right now. You're just going to sit there. Actually, you know what? We'll just aid protocol you. Nah, you can just sit there. It's fine.
Standing fast.
Alright, they're walking in front. So we're going to try and assassinate the heck out of these guys. Payne, you're going to overwatch for me.
Eyes on the prize.
We're gonna have... Who else is gonna overwatch for me? Glitch, you're gonna move over to here and overwatch for me.
Rolling.
I'm gonna start this off with a bang.
Eyes on the prize.
Schultz, you're gonna move over to here and overwatch for me.
Move into position.
We're not gonna overwatch with our assault.
Roger, I've got my eyes on.
And Baller... Let's say hello.
Bombs away!
Hello there, friends! Surprise! You gonna react?
We're spotted.
Hello, friends! Not bad shooting there, sniper. Misses, and alright, commander's down. That's why we kept our assault in reserve.
That is not good.
Good riddance.
Alrighty. Everyone there is dead. We walk around here and we shotgun the guy who lived. Take him out, please. Thank you. That's a dead stun lancer. And that is how we say hello. Alright, let's move up here a little bit. Schultz, you're gonna head over here to the low cover.
Moving to designated coordinates.
You don't see anything yet, that's to be expected. Lynch, I'm gonna... Ooh, train's over here. That looks like one of those supply crates we're supposed to be getting. I'm hesitant to move in this direction, because I don't want
to
reveal anything new,
position.
But we're gonna have to move at some point, so let's get moving. Glitch, you're gonna move up here as well.
On the move.
And baller. You're actually going to come over here. I didn't realize that this is the direction they're actually set up in. You're going to overwatch for me, Visser, because I have a feeling we're going to have a lot of people coming. Schultz, you've already taken one action. You're just going to overwatch here.
Covering now.
Payne, you're going to book it over to this high cover, I think.
Running.
As long as you don't spot anything all of a sudden from being one tile further forward, we should be fine. Alright, overwatches. Let's see what happens. Nothing. Good. Alright, so there's stuff over here, but it looks like the way we need to go is over in this direction to get what's on the train. I don't know exactly how this works, but it seems like those crates are what we need to come and get. So let's move up with Glitch over to this high cover and see if we discover anything new. Sounds like we did. It's our first snake!
Without the introduction of human DNA, these creatures once operating under the guise of Venmen now show their true form. A purely reptilian species.
No reason for them to hide. The aliens don't need an infiltration unit anymore.
Alrighty, this could be a problem. We now have a snake on the battlefield. So let's send Visser over to here.
Seems doable.
Can you suppress the snake for me? I don't know if suppression will protect you from things like their special ability, but I hope it will. Schultz, if I move you up over to here, can you do anything to these guys? They have two stun lancers and a snake. Alright, Schultz, you're going to move up. They're going to be pushing up on us, so we probably want to set up some overwatches here. Can I grenade both of these guys? No. It doesn't look like any of my grenade positions will be able to hit both of them. Not quite in range. Okay, well, we gotta pick and choose then. Excuse me. Kim can only see the guy in the front, so I guess what makes the most sense is that we blow up his cover and then try and take him out with Schultz. This shouldn't hurt our future maneuverability either, but should make things a bit easier. I don't know if we can blow up this rock, but we're gonna try. Yes, we can. Alright, so Kim should be able to take him out now. So we want to try and remove as many of these guys as possible. 75% chance. Don't mess this up, Kim. Kim takes him down. Good. Alright, that's what we needed. So this snake is still a worrisome element, but we'll deal. This guy's also a problem, but we'll hopefully be able to deal. Lynch, you're going to move up to here.
On the move.
Glitch, you can combat protocol the snake for 2 damage. That doesn't make a difference here. If you go to take a shot, you only have a 55% chance to hit the stun lancer, and he's the one we really need to deal with. So what I'm thinking we do here, Baller is going to suppression the snake. We're going to have Lynch blow up the position here with a grenade, and then hopefully our support can follow up to kill them. This should do the trick, hopefully. We have the toss, which is the important thing. Now, it's a very long-range shot for our support here to follow up on, but a 75% chance to hit's pretty good. And he's down, which is what we wanted.
Hostile terminated.
Good. And now we're going to suppress the snake. This might not prevent them from using their special ability, which is what I'm worried about. Ooh, it worked. Okay, good.
There's heavy fire in the zone.
That was exactly what we wanted to have happen. They failed to grab us. Snakes can grab you with their tongue. Oh, and they could have second action, too.
I'm taking
Thankfully,
fire.
They missed with that as well because of the suppression. Sounds like the suppression worked exactly as I hoped it would. We totally wasted that snake's turn. Alright, now we need to push up here so we can attack them through their cover. From here should be a flank.
Order's
it might
covered.
Trigger new
Over
enemies,
here.
Though. Nope, no new enemies. And we have a flank shot here at the snake. Ooh, critical. He's down to 1. So we can guaranteed kill him with one of the people. No, he's down to two. Ah. Alright, well, we can still guaranteed kill him. It's just going to take more shots. Kim can't see anything, though, so we're going to move her up so she's actually in a position where she's more useful. That tree blocked her line of sight, I guess. From here, she can take a 33% chance pistol shot, but that's pretty bad. Glitch, I could move you up and guarantee the kill with the combat protocol, and I think that's what we're going to do here. I want to move over to this, though, and see if we can actually do anything with that. I don't know how these things work. This one's glowing yellow, as is this one. As is that one. They're all glowing yellow. Okay, so we're going to send Glitch over to here.
Moving
Come on,
to
Mackenzie.
Position.
Can I loot this thing? Is that how this works? It doesn't look like you can do anything to it. Avoid destroying critical supplies. That's how it works. Okay. Combat protocol. Go. That's a guaranteed kill. Get dead, snake. Alright, so we don't actually collect these items, we just have to not blow them up. That's fair. That's fair. Alright, Lynch, I'm gonna send you over to here.
Good
we're gonna need to regroup our team here to make sure that we don't run into trouble.
That's the equipment we're after. We'll have to do our best to avoid destroying the gear while we secure the area.
Yeah, Central, thanks for telling me that after I already figured it out. Alright, Kim, you're going to move over to this high cover, I guess.
Order's confirmed. On the move!
I want to get you over the top, but that first move was not a great strategic position for trying to do that. And Baller, I don't know where to put you. I kind of want to stick you together with our other Grenadier, but I don't know if that's a good idea. We'll move you over to here for now. We're probably going to have to dash with our second Grenadier to keep them together. Because Visser's over here now, we want to make sure we don't spread ourselves out too thin.
Scanning.
Nothing happened there yet. Good. Alright, Schultz, you need to run. You need to run all the way back over here. You're not going to be useful this turn, but honestly, I'm okay with that, since we haven't discovered anything yet, and you were all by yourself. Which is never good. Alright, let's move our sniper up onto this position. They might discover new enemies for us, but they wouldn't have been able to help fight them anyway, so they might as well move. Are there more supply crates over here? Or are they all on the train? It looks like they are all on the train. That's fine. I'm guessing the next set of enemies are going to be at the front of the train. We'll move up to here with Mackenzie and see if there's anything hiding on this side. Doesn't look like there is, which I'm fine with. Baller, you're going to move over to here.
I can handle that.
We're going to spend a turn regrouping because there's no need to rush right now. And it would be much better for us to be in a prepared position than to be in an unprepared one. So, you're ready. You can overwatch there. You have your free reload. You're going to reload, Baller, because you did your suppression last turn to save us from the snake. You're going to reload as well.
Locked and loaded!
And I'm going to have Mackenzie put up an overwatch just in case something rushes us. Nothing did. Okay. Baller, I'm going to send you over to these crates, I think. Actually, no. I think I'm going to send you over to this rock.
I'm going.
Still nothing. Alright, let's send our assault over to here.
Rolling.
Still nothing. We gotta be careful with how we move right now. Let's move Mackenzie over to here.
On your order.
Still nothing. Alright. I'm okay with this, because our team's still pretty spread out.
Solid copy.
Bring Schultz up. They're in cover, but it doesn't matter right now, because nothing knows where we are. I probably would have liked to reload with them, but they're gonna hopefully be our Grenadier rather than our Reacher. And Kim, there's not really a good place to put you at all. I'm just gonna stick you over here.
Roger that!
Might have been better where you were, but this gives you a line of sight in this direction, which might be better. And here, you're gonna pistol overwatch for us. You're going to overwatch for us too, and I guess you're gonna reload this time.
Reloaded!
We don't know where the aliens are, and that's the biggest concern right now. Alright, let's take Baller and move up to here. This is almost certainly going to reveal them.
Whatever you say. Advent forces.
There they are. There's one on the roof. Is that all? Come on, game. Nope, there's three on the roof. Alright. Alright. It's fine. We can deal with this. They're clustered together, which is really good. So I can do that to them. Don't know if I can get their cover and hurt them in the same shot, but we can at least get their cover. Yeah, I don't know what the best grenade here would be. Let's roll back for a second, though. We do see something explosive nearby. What's the explosive thing? Oh, it's those barrels there right beside the valuables that we need to not shoot. Okay, that's fair. Okay. How is the best way to do this? Lynch, I guess you're gonna move up to here, probably? You might just overwatch this turn to make them come to you, because you couldn't see them from there. Glitch, I could move you over to here. That's not terrible. It's high cover. It might be too close, but we'll see. We want to try and use Schultz as our breaker. I don't know if I can get close enough to fire a grenade from there. And Kim definitely needs to move, because she's exposed right now. So Kim, I'm going to stick you beside this truck.
Moving to
in this high cover. You can take a pistol shot at one of them, because you can't do anything else anyway. Do not shoot the explodey barrel. But first, we're going to blow their cover. So we're going to have to use Baller for this, I think. Maybe if I move Schultz over to here, I can take a shot. We're really packing in around this car, which is dangerous. I don't know if it can explode, since it doesn't have any wheels on it, so it might not have any gas left. Okay, we can use this as a break. It's better to try and break both of their covers, I think. But I really want to hurt that, we want to kill the Stunt Lancer. That's more important right now. Grenades away. This is probably the last pack on this mission, so if we can clear these guys, we'll be in good shape. Let's grab Kim and take a pistol shot at the exposed soldier. 43% chance. I don't know if he's actually counting as exposed from here, but we'll shoot him anyway. Can't grenade that far, can I? Definitely not. Alright. Take the shot from here, then. Or maybe overwatch him. That might actually be better. Because he's gonna come to us.
Moving to overwatch.
We know he will. Glitch, what can you shoot? Nothing great here. I might take Baller with a second grenade. I'd love to kill this guy. We have a 73% chance to kill him with Baller. Or I can fire a grenade here to take out that cover so somebody else can kill him. You know what? We're going to try and kill the Grenadier. I mean, the Stunt Lancer here, I think. Stick to the plan. 6 damage. That's a dead Stunt Lancer. So the Sectoid should probably try to reanimate him.
Well, how about that?
And I think what we're going to use with the rest of our team then is a bunch of Overwatches. I'd love to move up more aggressively with Lynch, though, so we might do that. Because I'd love to be able to get them in range to actually use their shotgun. From here, the range of actually hitting people is pretty darn low, 41%. I might do it anyway, just for fun. I'm going to set up an Overwatch with McKenzie. Nah, we're going to set up an Overwatch with Lynch too, actually. Because we know that Stun Lancer is going to be running at us. We know the reanimation's going to be happening, and that's fine. We can blow up his cover next turn and then take him out. He'll be an easy kill. We just don't want to get ambushed by the Stun Lancer when he runs at us. So here comes Glitch's shot. Good shooting. 3 damage. He's coming for you, so you better hit him. And there's the pistol. Another 2 damage. Good shot. And here's the shotgun. Misses. Ooh. Well, hopefully he can't get to you fast enough to be able to stun you. He does! 3 damage and a disorient. Okay, we're good. I don't know why I was so unlucky the first time I fought these guys, but every single time they hit somebody, they were instantly killed. This time it looks like we're getting off a little bit luckier here. So, we're gonna need to clear out the guy in the back here, and we're gonna do that using Schultz's grenade? Or Baller's grenade? I might use Baller's grenade on this one. Just make sure we clear out the rocks there and do a bit of damage.
Get ready for a surprise!
We're going to use the shotgun to kill the Stun Lancer. We're going to use a sniper to kill the Sectoid here, hopefully. If everything goes according to plan. Alright, Kim, normal shot. You have an easy hit here on this guy. 75% chance, though, is the best you can do. Alright, don't miss him, please. Good shooting, Kim. Good shooting. And that is a double kill. You get the kill on the zombie as well. I don't know if that doubles the experience they get for the kill, but it might. Got a promotion anyway, so that's good news. And we're going to use our assault to try and take this kill here. So let's grab Lynch. Run up next to this guy, shotgun and point blank, please. Hello. Kill him. I love those expressions there as they watch the body fly past. Only saw them for a split second, but they're pretty good.
Burning through ammo.
Is that everything? Confirmed. Yes, it is.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
Having five people status helps confirmed. A lot, mission turns out. Having five people helps a lot. We only killed 9 out of 10 enemies, though. Why is that? That's weird. Maybe there was a faceless on the map that we never found? I don't know why it says that, but it says we killed them all, so I'm just going to assume we did. Good mission there, team. Having five people makes a big difference. Kim's happy with herself. See that smug grin there for a second? She's thrilled. I wonder how much reward we get from this for saving all of the goods on the train. 100% successful shot percentage? What? That's not true. We missed an overwatch. I guess that doesn't count. Weird. Let's see what our reward is. Good work, team.
I told the troops to expect the best, and that's what you've shown them, Commander.
Glitch got lightly wounded, but they'll be okay. We have another Blade Master or Phantom choice. We're choosing Phantom. I'm not going for swords. I just find them too unreliable. And Pain, you have the ability to go for Long Watch or Return Fire. I don't know if I want to make you a Revolver Soldier or a Sniper Overwatch yet, so I'm going to hold off on that for now. We might decide on that one later. For now, we'll continue. The 3 Illyrium cores, very nice. We can use those to make some fun stuff. We also got an Advent Officer Corpse, 5 Stunlancer Corpses, a Viper Corpse, a Sectoid Corpse, 63 Alien Alloys, that's really nice, 18 Illyrium Crystals, also very good, and 128 Supplies. That was a good mission. Now we have a Viper Autopsy. This creature is clearly reptilian in nature, although it appears to not be not only sentient, but also highly intelligent. Still, the underlying physiology is remarkably similar to a number of terrestrial species, including the venom sacs, which you might be able to synthesize and incorporate for use in our medical supplies. Alrighty. Intel is an important resource. We're going to make contact with different regions around the world. Yes, indeed. We're very low on the intel right now because we've just set up a second contact, but we'll hopefully get more soon. By very low, I mean we have 52, which is not terrible. Okay, so things are looking pretty good here. I think we might actually take Alexei off of this now. If we take a look at our armory, our soldier's wound time is down to pretty darn low. So I think we'll probably take them off of the there and send them to speed up the shielding the power core, because we need that. So I do that by... Oh, the... That's weird. Oh, because I'm not in the facilities view.
Hey,
that's
Commander.
Why. This is the view I need to be in. Remove him. Yeah. No. That removes the whole facility. Why would you want to do that? I just want to take him out. Alright, empty. I thought that was a really handy, easy way to remove people, but no, that removes the entire facility. I guess I was wrong about that one. Come on, let me get in here. I need to put the
engineer in here. I probably could have saved a lot of time repairing the ship's systems if we had any idea how to translate the language. Unfortunately, we don't come across many linguists.
There we go. Down to 13 days' time on the shielding of the power core. That should help a little bit. Oh boy. Alright, we have an empty spot here, but we have no powers. We can't build anything there yet anyway. We could get some power by building another relay, but I don't know if we want to do that just yet. We have 457 supplies. We should probably buy some cool stuff. But we don't have a lot of good stuff to buy yet, so I don't know what we want to get. We'll have to think about this. Either way, I think we're going to end this episode here for now. Thanks for watching, everyone. This has been Vanguard of Valor, playing a little bit of XCOM 2 here for you. Finally getting to bring 5 people on a mission. Next time, we're probably going to go to that black site, because that looks like it's pretty darn important. So, you look forward to that. For now, though, this has been Vanguard of Valor. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know what you thought about the video in the comments below, and by liking the video or disliking it,
contact,
and I'll see you next time.
Bye-bye. After the council dissolved.